May our dear Lord keep you in his steadfast peace, heart dwellers. Amen. I have to tell you, some of us are not long for this world. The rapture is imminent. There are more dynamics at work concerning this than you or I know of. For this reason, we must keep our hearts and minds on Jesus. This is our work. In the words of Jesus, this is the work of God, that you believe in the one he has sent. John 6:21. We belong to Christ Jesus as his unique possession, and he will keep us from the hours of darkness foretold in Scripture. We have only to keep our eyes on him. He is continually standing by us so that we may be sure that he is always there, always ready to help. We need only to focus on him, the solution, and not on all the problems that surround us each day or the ones that loom on the horizon. None of them are too great for him. He knew way ahead of time and has already arranged provision to help us. Oh Lord, give us strength for what is to come. All I know is that things are about to take a dramatic turn, a very dramatic turn. Ezekiel had a vision of President Trump and Melania being taken in the rapture. If this was from the Lord and the rapture is soon, then he may not get a chance to serve another term. I pray and hope it is not true. Last night, Ezekiel was keeping watch all night long. He felt the rapture just hanging in the air, ready to happen at any moment. Many of us, especially the core members, have been receiving scripture readings at the Lord's Supper, and all of them are about the rapture. We just cannot open a book or pull a card or do anything that it doesn't refer to the coming of the Lord. It certainly is no coincidence. The frequency is far beyond that possibility. He is telling us he is about to step through the door and take his bride. Are you ready? Keep watch, dear ones. Prepare your hearts. Make frequent confessions. Do not allow sin to cling to you. Do not give yourself permission to judge others. Replace that judgment with love and good resolution to pray for them while you examine your own interior and put your finger on your own iniquities that are far more serious than your brothers or sisters. Lord, have you anything to say? Jesus began, "My precious ones, I cannot wait to have you in heaven with me. Indeed, you are in the very last seconds before I take you to myself. You have waited long and hard for this day, and now it approaches. Keep yourselves clean, dear ones. Do all you can to love those around you, especially your enemies, and leave a lasting impression of my love. Be my fragrance in this dark, dark world. Things are not as they seem in the world in this moment. Truly, you are on the razor's edge of calamity, for the time has finally come to judge the world. Now that you are aware of the trafficked children around the world, the rampant satanic practices of torturing and murdering children from the womb to their teens, you can see that things are far more evil than anyone could even guess. Those you have admired in Hollywood are some of the worst specimens of human being on the planet. They actually torture little children to drain them of their adrenaline, which they drink, and maintains their bodies so they appear to be less than 30 years old, while in actuality they're in their 50s and 60s. The intake of a child's blood loaded with adrenochrome is their secret. They have no remorse for these heinous acts of cruelty, for they believe it is their privilege. So much more iniquity goes on, my people. Things you never would have thought could happen. I am telling you this because the rapture is so well justified in my Father's eyes. The wickedness has gone beyond the boundaries of human behavior and decency. Even animals have more dignity than this corrupt generation. Satan has planned well to bring into fruition the very generation that will support his evil plans. Yet my grace shall not be lacking. I intend to show my power and my mercy to those who have been led astray from birth. I know there is much you do not understand, beloved. I know your list of questions goes on endlessly, and that is why I have asked you to trust what I am doing and what I am allowing. I have surrounded you with souls that hear my voice and understand my ways, and they shall take your place when you are gone. You do not have to worry. What I have begun through you will continue in the hands of holy and capable people that I have chosen to lead in these end times. What I have begun, I will continue and bring to fruition. When you return to the earth, you shall be astounded at what has taken place since you left. Truth will be passed on. Conversions will continue. Little ones shall find refuge in me, and a standard of holiness will be established for the resurrection of my church. All of this only because my brides obeyed. So I want you to enjoy the little time left to you being with me, writing music and singing it too, and enjoy your work as you come into eternity where it will be endless and glorious. So much to look forward to. So much. I have not disclosed to you much of what shall be accomplished because of your very littleness and trust in me. But you will see, and if it were possible at that time, have trouble believing. I write beautifully with broken pencils. And there are little ones, broken, just as you are, and I shall continue to write with them. There is coming a whole new standard to true holiness. No longer is it the college degree, the alphabet soup after the name. No. It is the pure of heart, the sincere of heart, that I shall write through, paint through, make music through, heal through, and govern my church with. Littleness, littleness, littleness. What great things I can do with littleness. And for all of you who have dreams yet untapped, understand that when I cleanse this earth of the filth, you will be using those gifts to reform hungry souls. You will be put in charge of their development and formation with the assistance of my Holy Spirit, angels, and every spiritual gift flowing freely from within you. I tell you this because you are not to lament what you didn't get done. When I finish with this earth, I will need you to rebuild, to support and encourage, to build up my way upon the earth. No longer shall corruption reign terror over those chosen to lead. No longer will there be blackmail, threats, and bribes. No longer will those in charge seek their own good, but rather the good of the people and my will. My angels shall patrol and come to the aid of my servants, as well as crush those who attempt the ways of evil and corruption. Lying, stealing, cheating, and so many other grave sins that have ruled over societies shall no longer keep their grip. Those who attempt such things will be severely punished, and only the good will prosper. Yet my compassion is without limit, and I shall establish programs to heal and re-educate those who are twisted by sin. Yes, there will be survivors who have a sinful past. The earth will not be cleansed of those who have done evil, yet they will have the opportunity to repent and be reformed. I am the God of mercy. O beloved ones, your gifts will grow and shine and bear the most glorious fruit. You shall be beacons of light and harbors of love and safety for the wounded, the injured ones. You shall be my servants of light who seek only to heal and love degenerate mankind and those who have suffered unbelievable torments. All shall be healed. None shall be left crippled emotionally, mentally, or physically. All shall be reformed by my love. And you, my bride, will be the emissaries of this healing and reformation. You shall walk in my anointing, my power, my love and compassion, and as you have received freely, you shall impart freely. This is my kingdom come, and my will being done. So I say to you, do not mourn over the loss of time and being raptured. I did not give you these gifts just to be wasted. No, I gave them to be cultivated and used. In heaven, you will learn to minister as the angels do and be fully prepared to bring your healing gifts to earth, whether they be writing, art, music, or other tools. All will be used to restore and heal. So lift up your heads. Your redemption draws nigh. Prepare your hearts. Keep your wedding dress clean and fill your lamps in readiness. For behold, I come.